My name is Jim Dunn, and I'm a professor of agricultural economics. I teach in the Agribusiness Management program, and I'm an undergraduate coordinator for that program. And this particular program is greatly offered by the College of Business and College of Agricultural Sciences. And so our students are required to take the business core, which includes accounting and finance and management, marketing, things like that. And then they take a variety of courses in agribusiness management that are unique to the major. There are a wide variety of people in this major. Many of them have no ties to agriculture or rural America at all. They come from Brooklyn and Philadelphia and places like that, but they're interested in food. And people in our major do all kinds of different things. That includes a variety of things associated with food and agriculture, starting from selling things to farmers, being farmers, buying things from farmers, processing the materials from farms, a variety of things such as that, and then working for grocery stores, restaurants, and doing a variety of other things in the world of business that have nothing to do with agribusiness, but the skills that they learn in this major apply to any business, but they're particularly helpful if you're involved in things that are doing agriculture and food. We have two or three different paths for students coming here. Some people are very interested in business itself, and they come in into the major because they like the applied nature of it compared to some of the things that happen in other parts of the university. And then there are people that are very interested in agriculture but realize that the business part of agriculture is what really leads to the profitability or failure of your farm or firm. And so, you know, the problems associated with controlling weeds are certainly important to being a successful farmer, but it ultimately is the money. And the same is true of other businesses. So, it's a lot easier to get technical help than it is to get business help. And then we have people that get in here for some other reason, whatever it might be. They want to run a small business or something like that. It's very difficult to say what it all amounts to, but certainly the people who come from the business world, from the people coming from the agricultural groups, are the two main students. Almost all of our students do at least one internship. Several of them will do two, and occasionally somebody will do three. And so the firms that hire our students are very interested in offering them the opportunity to do internships. As a way to convince them that they might want to work for their firm in the future, and also as a bit of a dry run to see if they want to hire this person. And they also have a variety of problems that are best dealt with by somebody that's just there for a short period of time, and you don't want to take somebody away from their regular job to do these things. And so they bring these people in and assign them special projects that no one else can really get around to. Big companies and small. For example, Tyson Foods hires a number of our students. The Farm Credit System hires a number of our students and other agricultural banks. A whole bunch of farm supply companies, whether it be equipment, fertilizer, food, chemicals, hire our students. The government hires them in a variety of ways. And then smaller things that you might not have heard of would have one or two people in a relatively small operation. So we have some of the biggest companies in the world and some of the smallest hire our students. We certainly have some people that are very interested in starting their own business. And we have, I can think of two students that graduated last year and had businesses ongoing while they were students, and they had to hustle away from college and go do whatever it was they do on the side. And they structured their courses with those businesses in mind. And other people are more interested in working for somebody else, have a little bit more structured job, and don't have all of the risks and responsibilities of making a new system. As near as I can tell, everybody that came out of this major, since I've been a coordinator for the last 4 or 5 years, has gotten a job in their major. Some of them have more opportunities than others, because of a variety of things that are associated with them, including their academic performance.